everyone, this is Sri Varalakshmi Moderi. Welcome back to my channel. Today I bought you some of the PYQs which are relevant to your IIIT entrance examination revision. Without delay, let's start our topic. First of all, they given about the basic bit. The adjacent sides of a parallelogram are 6 cm and 8 cm and the angle between them is 30 degrees. Then the area of the parallelogram B. We all know that area of the parallelogram is base into height. Now let me locate a parallelogram in this way. This is the parallelogram. According to him, he said that 6 cm and 8 cm are adjacent side, and it is angle between them is 30. So you can write it is in this way. This is the 30, 6, some value we don't know how much. I need this h. H is nothing but h means height. How to find out this height? You can find out by using sin 30. Sin 30 is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. 1/2 equal to opposite value is anyhow h by hypotenuse is 6 because I drawn a perpendicular. Then h is equal to 3 cm. Already I have said that what is the area of the parallelogram is base into height. Base is the, we drawn the height to the side 8 cm. Now area of the parallelogram is base into height, where base is equal to what? 8 here, height is what? 3. 8 threes are 24 cm square. Then option 1 is correct. Now coming to the second problem, the mean of 5 numbers is 30. One number is excluded, the mean becomes 28, the excluded number. Whenever we want to find out excluded number, very simple. We should find out the previously how much sum is there. 5 into 30, 150. And afterwards, new sum is how much? Now only 4 numbers are there because one number was excluded, 4 into 28. You may get it here 112. 150 minus 112, which is equal to 38. That is the correct answer. Let's move to the problem number 3. The sum of 3 numbers are in a GP is 38 and their product is 1728. The greatest number of them is. We all know that whenever the 3 numbers are in the EAP, they are consecutive, maybe sum or product, and they are asking. If it is AP means we should take A minus D, comma A, comma A plus D are the 3 terms of the AP. But whenever GP is there, A by R, comma A, comma AR be the 3 terms in the GP. They are saying the product of the 3 terms is equal to 1728. Product means you know multiplication. A cube equal to 1728. Clearly A equal to cube root of 1728. You know cube root of 1728 is equal to 12. We got the A value is 12. They are asking you to find out still more. All these are in the form of 24, 18, 16, 8. Definitely it must be comes in the 12 table, then only it will be. Guess is 24. Whether that is 24 or not, let us see that. Because they have given that their sum is how much? 38. 38 is the sum means how can we write? A by R plus A plus AR is equal to 38. 12 by R plus 12 plus 12 R is equal to 38. Now take out 12 is common. What is left over? 1 by R plus 1 plus R is equal to 38. Simplify it. After simplifying that, we got a quadratic equation of 12 R square minus 26 R plus 12 equal to 0. Again, it is coming in the 2 table. I have a taken 2 as out, then I got the 6R square minus 13R plus R 6 equal to 0. Let us factorize now. After factorizing, we got that R equal to 3 by 2 or R equal to 2 by 3. We want the greatest among them, that is A naught a by r, a r among them, a r is the greatest. So a value is anyhow 12 and r value either 2/3 or 3/2 we should take. Greatest value means we have to take common ratio is more than that. That's why 3/2 we taken. It is 18. So 18 is our required one number. But if we were taken 24, yes, because of guess we taken. But whether that guess we confirmed it, no. That is why we have verified. We got the answer is 18. The point of intersection of less than and more than ogive curves is 25, 30. Usually x coordinate of the intersection of the both the ogives represents that median, where y coordinate is its cumulative frequency value. So answer is 25 is the answer. Let's move to the next one. A coin is tossed successfully 3 times. The probability of getting exactly 1 head or 2 heads, nothing but they are R they are giving. R means we know that A union B is equal to P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B it will be. But here no intersection. Exactly 1 head and exactly 2 heads won't be appear in the same event. So this is 0. So how many exactly 1 head? Let us see that. Exactly 1 head D 1, 2, 3. So it's a 3/8 plus exactly 2 heads 1, 1, nothing but totally 3. 3/8 plus 3/8 is 6/8, which is equal to 3/4. The mean of first 5 prime numbers, it's a very simple. You can do it. 2 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 11/5. Add it. 17 plus nothing but 28/5, which is equal to 5.6. The length of the base and hypotenuse of a right angle triangle are 5 and 13. So in a right angled triangle, base is 5 and hypotenuse is 13. Obviously by using Pythagoras you can find out the x value is equal to 12. How means 13 square equal to x square plus 5 square, then 169 equal to x square plus 25 will give you x square is equal to 144, then x equal to 12. You know that area of the right angle triangle equal to half into leg 1 into leg 2. That means you can write it as half into leg 1 is 5, leg 2 is 12, which is 30 centimeter square. Look at the problem number 8. If lines L and M are parallel as shown below, then the value of x is very simple value. Now look at it, or maybe this one. If you observe that this is 90 degrees alternate interior angle, this is also 90. Then this total will be alternate interior with this. That means you can write that 90 plus x degrees equal to 125. As it is alternative interior angle with the 125 degrees. Obviously x value is equal to 35 degrees, then option 1. Let's move to the next problem. The ratio of the side and height of an equilateral triangle is what? We know side of your equilateral triangle, let us assume it as A, and height of an equilateral triangle, let us take it as √3/2 into A. A cancel. 1:√3/2 will give you 2:√3. Then look at the problem number 10. 2 tan 30 degrees by 1 minus tan square 30 degrees. In the previous video also like this problem I have explained, which is equal to tan into 2 into theta. Tan into, let us take that 30 degrees is theta, then tan 2 into 30, which is equal to tan 60. Maybe it is in the form of 2 tan theta by 1 plus tan square theta. Usually we should take it as sin 2 theta. 1 minus tan square theta by 1 plus tan square theta is equal to cos 2 theta. Then 2 tan theta by 1 minus tan square theta is tan 2 theta. coordinates of the center of the circle whose endpoints of the diameter is 9 comma 3 and 1 comma 1. 9 comma 3, 1 comma minus 1. What is the center of the circle will be midpoint of the diameter. Midpoint formula you already know. X1 plus X2 by 2 comma Y1 plus Y2 by 2. That means 9 plus 1 by 2 comma 3 minus 1 by 2 will give you 10 by 2 comma 2 by 2 value is 1. So 5 comma 1 will be the answer. Now look at the next problem. The value of 1 plus cos theta by root of 1 minus cos. This problems we discussed many times. So whenever it is 1 plus cos theta is there, think that 1 by sin theta value. What is that? Its value is secant. Its value is cosecant theta. Plus cos by sin value is, what is it? Its value is cot theta. Plus, if minus is there, minus take it. Cosecant theta minus cot theta. Getting cancelled, you will get 2 cosecant theta. Look at the problem number 13. Triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR with BC by QR is equal to 1 by 3, then area. We already know that area of triangle PQR by triangle ABC can be written as PQ by AB whole square equal to QR by BC whole square equal to RP by CA whole square. PQ by AB is nothing but, we don't know, but QR by AC you can write, that is 3 by 1 whole square will give you 9 by 1, simply 9. Let's move to the next problem. If you have observed the problem number 14, if alpha comma beta comma gamma are the zeros of a polynomial 5x cube plus 2x square minus 3x plus 50, then the value of alpha beta gamma by alpha plus beta plus gamma. We all know that alpha beta gamma nothing but sum of the zeros of the cubic polynomial can be written as minus b by a, where product is minus d by a. So let me write here minus d by a by sum is minus b by a getting cancelled, answer is plus d by b, means constant term take it as, that is 50. And what is the x square coefficient, which is a b? Let us take it is a, b, c and d. 50 by 2, which is equal to 25. Now look at the 15th one. X cube minus 3x square plus x plus 1 has a minus b comma a plus b as its zeros, then the value of ab, we already know that whenever the roots are in the form of a minus b, a and a plus b, their sum is equal to minus b by a. B and B getting cancelled, 3A is equal to minus B by A. What is minus B by A means here? 3 by 1. Then A value is equal to 1. Now look at the problem number 16. In the given figure, DE is parallel to BC. Okay, DE parallel to BC. AE is to EC, AE is to EC, which is 4 is to 7, so 4K and 7K, let us think. Anyhow, these are parallel, we can write that ADE triangle is going to be similar with triangle ABC. AE is to EC is 4K and 7K, then DE East to BC will be what? We all know that we can write the CPST for any two triangles are similar to each other. They are AD by AB equal to DE by BC is equal to AE by AC. AD and AB information we haven't known, but we know about AE and AC. That is DE by BC is equal to AE, value is 4K. AC means 4K plus 7K, which is 11K. So 4:11 is the required one. Let's move to the next problem. Look at the problem number 17, which is very important model. The angles of a triangle are 30 degrees, 60 degrees, 90 degrees. Then the ratio of their sides is 1:2, 2:3 or 2:3:1 or 1:3√3:2 or 1:2, 1:2, 2:3. Whenever they are asking that to find out the ratio of their corresponding sides, first of all, if you want for the 30, 60 and 90, take a one equilateral triangle. We all know that angle in an equilateral triangle is 60 degrees. Maybe if I have taken the angular bisector of one of the angle as 30, 30, 30, so it is 60, definitely it is 90, as we know that in an equilateral triangle the angular bisector itself acts as a median as well as the perpendicular bisector also. So if you observe that, we got the required values 30, 60 and 90. Let me take the 2A is the side of the equilateral triangle. So A. I need this particular value X. A, B, C and D. In triangle ABC, find out the AC value. 2A whole square equal to A square plus X square. 4A square equal to A square plus X square. X square equal to 3A square. Then X equal to √3 into A. X equal to √3 into A. They are asking you to find out corresponding angles for 30, 60 and 90. What is the side opposite to 30 degrees? That is a small a. What is the side that opposite to the 60 degrees? X. What is the side that opposite to 90 degrees? 2a. A is to √3, A is to 2A. A gone cancel. 1:√3:2 is the required one. Let's move to the next one. The number of 3-digit numbers that are divisible by 3 are. Which numbers are divisible by 3 means 3-digit number starts from the 100, 101, 102, 103 and so on, 999. In the starting number, which is a 3-digit number and also divisible by 3, is 102. So our numbers starts from the 102. 102 comma next number is 105. Next number is the, and so on, last number 999. If you have observed what is the A value, take it. A is 102. Common difference is anyhow 3. And what is the AN value is 999. A plus N minus 1 into D equal to 999. What is the A value? 102. Plus N minus 1 into 3 equal to 999. Try to simplify it. N is equal to 300. Totally 300 numbers are there. Look at that. It is option 4. A cylinder, a cone and a sphere are of same radius, same height. The ratio of their curved surface area R. Problem is very simple and it is direct from your textbook. Let's do now. There is a cylinder, cone and sphere are having the same radius, they said, okay. But their height is, if you observe that, then the height of the cylinder is nothing but the diameter of the sphere. That's why height equal to 2r. Then definitely cone height also 2r. Length, the slant height of the cone, you know that r square plus h square. L square equal to root over r square plus h square, where r square plus h means 2r whole square. L is equal to root over 5r square, then L equal to root 5 into r. Just find out what is the CSA of the each and every given. CSA of a sphere is, we know, 4 pi r square. CSA of the cylinder formula is 2 pi r h. 2 pi into r into h value is anyhow 2r. So 4 pi r square. What is the CSA of the cone is equal to pi into r into l. Pi r into l value root 5 r. Then root 5 pi r square will be the required CSA. Now CSA of cylinder is 2. Cone is to sphere is 4 pi r square is to root 5 pi r square is to 4 pi r square. Pi r square, pi r square getting cancelled. 4 is to root 5 is to 4 will be the required one. Let's move to the next problem. If the quadratic equation x square plus bx plus c equal to 0 has two real and equal roots, then obviously the discriminant is equal to 0. Now coming to the problem number 21. If 2 by 3 and minus 3 are the roots of the equation x square plus 7x plus b equal to 0, then the value of a plus b they asked you. To find out this one, first of all name the given one is as alpha and it is beta. We know alpha plus beta is minus b by a, nothing but minus 7 by a. What is alpha plus beta is 2 by 3 minus 3 by 1, which is equal to minus 7 by 8. 2 minus 9 by 3 equal to minus 7 by 8 will be minus 7 by 3 equal to minus 7 by 8, getting cancelled, a equal to 3. Now the product is a, alpha into beta equal to c by a. What is the product is here? Product means 2 by 3 into minus 3 equals c by a. C by a means here constant term b by a. But a value already we got 3. So b value is equal to minus 6. A plus b means minus 6 plus 3. Answer is minus 3. Look at the problem number 22. The sum of ages of father and his son in years is 60 and twice the difference of their ages is 40. The age of the father in years B is very very simple problem. Father and son present ages are, let's assume that X and Y are their present ages. The sum of the age of a father and son is X plus Y is equal to 60. And twice the difference between their ages is 2 times of x minus y is 40. Then can we express x minus y as 2 and 40 means it's a 20. Think it's an equation 2 and it is an equation 1. Solve equation 1 and 2, x plus y equal to 60 and x minus y equal to 20. Try to solve it. 2x is equal to 80 where x is equal to 40. That means age of the father is 40 years. Is present age is 40 years. That is option 3. Let's move to the problem number 23. Look at the problem number 23. One equation of a pair of dependent linear equation is minus 5x plus 7y minus 2 equal to 0. The other equation can be the pair of dependent linear equation. Dependent means they are indirectly, they are coincidental lines. What kind of line? They are coincidental line. So what are the coincidental lines? Is minus 5x plus 7y minus 2 equal to 0. If you observe that dependent lines means a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2 should be. But here minus 5 is there. With what number we multiply, we will get that either minus 10x is nothing but 2. Let's multiply with 2. Now if you observe that, then the resultant equation will be minus 10x if we multiplied with 2 plus 14y minus 4 is equal to 0. But minus 10x plus 14y is somehow matching, but here minus 4 will become plus 4, so it is wrong. Even it is also wrong. Go for the, maybe it is multiplied with minus 2. That means minus 5x plus 7y minus 2 is equal to 0, which multiplying with minus 2 means 10x minus 14y plus 4 is equal to 0. Here it will become plus 4, then option is 2. Coming to the problem number 24, the HCF of 2 power 315 minus 1 and 2 power 25 minus 1 is, usually if it is power is having high power, can we find out the HCF? No, we can't find out. Then what is the solution to find out it is? Now can I express the 2 power 5 into 63 minus 1 and 2 power 5 into 5 minus 1? Can we express 315 is 5 into 63, 25 is 5 into 5, 2 power 5 whole power 63 minus 1 into 2 power 5 whole power 5 minus 1 will give you 32 whole power 63 minus 1 comma 32 whole power 5 minus 1. We all know that x power n minus y power n, where n is any natural number, definitely it is divisible by x minus y. Nothing but 32 whole power 63 minus 1 minus 1 power 63, definitely divisible by 32 minus 1, which is a 31. In the same manner, 32 whole power 5 minus 1 power 5 will be definitely divisible by 32 minus 1. Obviously 31. So the common factor is 31. Then answer is 31. It's divisible by 31. So their HCF is also 31. Let's move to the next problem. 3 metallic cubes of volumes 1 centimeter cube, 216 centimeter cube and 512 centimeter cube are melted and to form a new cube. So simply, volume of the bigger cube is equal to A1 cube plus A2 cube plus A3 cube, means volumes of all these. Then A cube is equal to, this volume is 1 and its volume is 216 and its volume is 512. If we add it, A cube is equal to 729. Definitely A value is cube root of 729, which is equal to 9. But they are asking you to find out what is the diagonal of the new cube. Diagonal formula is root 3 into side. We got the side of the new cube, that is 9. So its diagonal is 9 root 3. The set builder form of the set 1 by 3. It's better to go for the option Y. X by x square plus 1. X by x square plus 1 starts with 1. 1 plus 1 square plus 1. It's 1 by 2, but we are having 1 by 3. So this is wrong. Then go for this. 1 by 1 cube plus 1. Definitely 1 by 1 cube plus 1 means you will get that 1 by 2 here also wrong. Go for the rest of our option 2 and option 3. But which is the correct? How we know it? It is a natural number, but less than 5. Less than 5 natural number means 1, 2, 3, 4 terms only. But we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So option 3 is the correct. By the logic, we can do this kind of problem. Let's move to the next problem. If A cube plus B cube is to A cube minus B cube is equal to 133 is to 117, then what is the A is to B value they are asked you? Usually whenever they are asked in this way, we can use the compound and dividend of the ratios. That is, whenever A by B is equal to some X by Y, any two ratios are equal, definitely their compound and dividend ratio will be numerator plus denominator by numerator minus denominator, X plus Y by X minus Y. That means A cube plus B cube by A cube minus B cube is equal to 133 by 117. So the same thing, it's a numerator, it is the denominator. Then A cube plus B cube plus A cube minus B cube, numerator plus denominator by numerator minus denominator. That means A cube plus B cube minus A cube minus B cube, which is equal to 133 plus 117 by 133 minus 117. Simplify it. 2A cube by A cube plus B cube minus A cube plus B cube is equal to you may get it is 250 by it is 16. So clearly 2a cube by 2b cube is equal to 250 by 16, where a cube by b cube is equal to 125 by 8. Then a by b is equal to 5 by 2 whole cube and a by b whole cube. So a is to b equal to 5 is to 2. Then ratio is 5 is to 2. For a given data, the median is 39, and if each observation is decreased by 2, then the median of resulting data is, each observation is decreased by 2 means definitely median also will be decreased by 2, it is 37. They given that secant theta value is m plus m by 2 into root or mn, then what will be the sine theta? We discussed this one in a long back itself with the general form of the Pythagorean triplet. They are maybe single variable is there, we can write it as k square plus 1 comma 2k comma k square minus 1 is the general form of the Pythagorean triplet. And coming to if two variables like a and b means a square plus b square comma 2ab comma a square minus b square. Maybe in terms of roots it is there, obviously a plus b comma 2 into root ab comma a minus b. Then for the m and n, if you write what is the general form of the Pythagorean triplet in terms of m and n, m plus n comma root over mn comma m minus n. According to the given condition, secant is the hypotenuse by the edges and nothing but base. So hypotenuse is m plus n and base is 2 into root over 3 root over mn. Definitely what is left over, it is either perpendicular or opposite. So what is the sine theta means? Opposite by hypotenuse. Opposite is m minus n by hypotenuse m plus n. Then option 3 is correct. In what ratio the segment joining the points 4 is to 4 comma 6 and minus 7 comma minus 1 divide the x-axis? We know that whenever it is dividing the x-axis, y1 is to y2, that to minus. What is the minus 6 is to minus 1? We'll get that 6 is to 1 is the correct answer. Let's move to the next problem. The degree of the polynomial p of x is equal to x cube minus 3x square plus 7 into 7x power 4 plus 5. Usually take the highest degree terms and multiply it. What is their degree? X cube into x power 4 term, if we multiply x power 7, so answer is 7. When a number is, when a is divided by 9 and b is divided by 6 and leaves the remainder p and q, then the maximum value of p plus q is, obviously if it is divisible by 9 and it divisible by 6 means 9 plus 6 is 15. But whenever any number is divisible by 15, obviously its remainder is less than the 15, 0 to 14. In that maximum value from 0 to 14 is only 13. So we can take that 13 is the maximum remainder, we can get it. Problem number 33 is the quadratic polynomial with the zeros 5 minus 11 root 2 and 5 plus 11 root 2 is. We all know that if alpha and beta values they are given, how to find out the quadratic polynomial with the help of x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. Alpha is 5 plus 11 root 2, where beta is equal to 5 minus 11 root 2. Alpha plus beta is equal to, add both, you will get 10. Alpha into beta is equal to 5 plus 11 root 2 into 5 minus 11 root 2. 25 minus 11 root 2 whole square will give you 25 minus 121 into 2. 25 minus it is 142. Alpha beta is equal to minus 100 and sorry, it is 121 into 2 is 242. 25 minus 242 is equal to minus 217. What is the equation? Is x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. X square minus alpha plus beta value is equal to 10 into x plus minus 217. X square minus 10x minus 217 will be the required quadratic polynomial. Let's move to the next problem. The common ratio of the series cos 60 degrees plus cos cube 60 degrees plus cos power 5. Simply it is 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 whole cube plus 1 by 2 whole to the power of 5. Common ratio is nothing but the second term by first term ratio. 1 by 2 whole cube means 1 by 8 by 1 by 2. Then clearly we get that 1 by 4 is the required one.